As made clear in the recent Boba Fett Age of Rebellion comic, Boba didn't just hunt pirates or smugglers or members of the criminal syndicates. He hunted bounties, and whether they were affiliated with the Rebellion or Empire or something else entirely didn't matter to him. It was this dedication to his craft that would allow Boba Fett to become one of the greatest bounty hunters in the galaxy. Therefore, one would think it was almost impossible for Boba to be swayed in ways that would persuade him not to follow through on a bounty once he'd taken the job. But Legends includes a great moment with Boba Fett where he actually hesitated and then declined to make good on a bounty, refusing to kill Starkiller in a particular moment for Darth Vader. 6 months before the events of Episode 4, Boba Fett was contacted by Vader with a new assignment for him, a dangerous one that would see the bounty hunter earn triple his usual rate. As explained by Vader, and as fans of the second The Force Unleashed video game will recognize, Boba's target was none other than Starkiller, who he understood was a powerful Force wielder. Given the difficulty of the assignment, Boba allied with the bounty hunter Zasha to acquire Starkiller, who he'd formed a partnership with by this time, with the two bounty hunters living together on Nar Shaddaa. But by the time they got to Cato de Moidia, as per Vader's instructions, they found that the bounty was even more difficult than they imagined. They found Starkiller had single-handedly destroyed a city and defeated a massive beast known as the Gorog. And when the two bounty hunters were forced to finish what Starkiller started, Zasha declined to go any further, concluding that whatever the payment was, it wasn't enough. Boba wasn't surprised by this, and as Zasha requested that he decline the hunt for Starkiller as well, wanting him to go with her, Boba demonstrated his dedication to the job, explaining that he couldn't give up on the bounty once he accepted it. Declining Zasha's request, she told him that although he took the job, she hoped that the job didn't take him. Final words that, as we'll see, left a lasting impact on Boba. Boba then returned to focusing on the bounty to apprehend Starkiller for Vader, traveling to Kamino, where the Sith Lord gave him the key to acquiring his target. If he first apprehended Juno Eclipse, the former Imperial captain turned rebel, Starkiller would go to them. After Boba Fett interrogated a mechanic that assisted the Rebellion by helping to fix their starships, the bounty hunter had the name of the capital ship where he could locate Juno, the Salvation. Not long after, Boba would locate the Salvation within the Outer Rim, capturing Juno after the Imperial assets provided by Vader infiltrated and secured the starship. And perfectly in line with the bounty hunter's plan, the capture was witnessed by Starkiller, who was committed to rescuing Juno on Kamino. Importantly for our video here, it's the conversation that Boba Fett would then have with Juno on their way to Kamino that would again influence the bounty hunter significantly. After Juno revealed Vader's actions in cloning Starkiller, and with both of them understanding it was Starkiller's feelings for Juno that would allow him to fall into Vader's trap, Juno attempted to tap into the humanity of Boba Fett, explaining that the bounty hunter must have loved someone before at some point, and if so, he would not let Vader use her to destroy Starkiller. Clearly, Juno's words affected Boba, as after the communication was ended, he was visibly distraught and thinking about what she said. Ultimately, Boba would deliver Juno to Vader, and although he wanted to leave so that he wouldn't be anywhere near Starkiller once he arrived, Vader ordered the bounty hunter to remain on Kamino, with payment only being given once Starkiller was captured. Boba reluctantly agreed, and once the rebel fleet arrived, he joined in the fight on the side of the Imperials. Eventually, Boba would emerge upon a platform high above the final confrontation between Vader, Juno, and Starkiller. From here, Boba was able to witness Starkiller do everything he could to save Juno, her attempt to rescue both of them from Vader, and then the Sith Lord's brutal action in force pushing Juno to the platform far below them. After the bounty hunter was able to dispatch an attack by Jedi Master Ram Koda and Proxy, with the latter taking on the form of Boba's father Jango Fett, Boba would resume watching the events unfold between Vader and Starkiller. Setting up high above Starkiller and Vader, Boba would use an LD-1 target blaster rifle to target Starkiller, and prepared to make good on his bounty for the Sith Lord. While Boba Fett would watch as Starkiller ultimately showed Vader clemency, allowing him to be taken into Rebellion custody rather than executed there on Kamino, this had no profound effect on Boba, as he still prepared to collect his payday. When Boba then followed Starkiller over to Juno, watching as he apologized to her for not being able to save her in time, Boba began to hesitate. But as he then watched Juno miraculously regain consciousness, embracing Starkiller as she joyfully found that they were both still alive, Boba did everything he could to force himself to claim the bounty, removing his helmet and even resetting a number of times before finally putting his sights squarely on Starkiller. However, he just couldn't do it. As Boba Fett dropped the blaster rifle to his side, he told himself he would eventually get Starkiller and make good on the bounty, but not then, and definitely not like that. Proving that the job hadn't fully taken away his humanity, echoing back to the words of Zasha and Juno, Boba walked away as Starkiller and Juno had their moment together. But, just as we mentioned at the beginning, Boba was someone who hunted bounties. And staying true to that, as Starkiller and Juno's starship entered hyperspace, Boba was in full pursuit. So there we have it, the moment Boba Fett walked away from collecting the bounty on Starkiller. Thank you very much to all of the Patreon members of Star Wars Reading Club, as your support is so greatly appreciated. You can find all of our social media links and a link to our Star Wars gaming channel in the description below for updates and even more Star Wars content. We love making these videos, so why not subscribe for more fun Star Wars theories and discussions? Also, if you enjoyed the video, think about giving a like or leaving a comment. If not for me... for the Gorog.